Thank you so much, Jane and John. First tonight, there are a few things we hate more than being pigeonholed. So when the state government set about rebranding the state, was it asking for trouble? Well, what they've come up with instantly generated a massive reaction, both for and against. Now, shortly, we'll give you a chance to have your say. But first, here's Graham Archer with a look at the behind-the-scenes development and launch, which might help you decide.
This will certainly be a high-focus topic once it's released.
It was a night of sound and flurry signifying, well, let's hope, quite a lot. We have to admit, as a state, we can be a bit cringy. But you couldn't watch the extraordinary launch of Brand SA last night without being impressed by the effort.
It's very different to an ad campaign or to a marketing campaign.
You just want to hear him say, wow.
Wow?
Yeah, I would have said wow.
Close.
Brilliant.
You guys have done a great job.
How would you sum it up?
New.
One word? In the whole thing in one word?
One word.
Okay, inspiring.
Love it or otherwise, it's involved no shortage of brain power.
There's a lot of thinking that go into strong brands.
Recognising the good stuff that we have here, doing something about the bad stuff, regardless of whether we have a logo, is the secret of our future.
That said, the idea behind this is it doesn't matter how good we might be if the world doesn't know who or where we are. That's the message Premier Jay Weatherill took away from his London trip last year.
What it's about is it's about creating first and foremost awareness. Where is South Australia? I think we have to all agree that we are relatively unknown on the world stage. And secondly, it's about allowing people to see who South Australia really is, what our beliefs and values.
So how to condense that down to one idea people are prepared to embrace?
Can you brand an entire state?
That's a very good question. The answer to that is yes. We've never attempted it before, but what we're doing here is quite different to other attempts. We're talking about destination, or as it's more commonly known as place branding. So the answer to that is certainly yes, yes you can.
The government set Darren Thomas the task of finding that rabbit in the hat.
I obviously had my own thoughts and perceptions, but I thought it was important to have a completely open mind. Don't worry, there's plenty of people offering advice.
Darren, a self-made businessman who markets prime South Aussie meat to the world, is himself a fitting role model for the future.
We went out into the regions, community leaders, social leaders, farmers, people from the education sector, migration, immigrants.
That involved 6 months of meetings, consulting around 3,500 people.
We really have two areas of focus we want you to talk to us about today, and that's the role South Australia plays in your life and what your values are and what you think values are that South Australians share.
South Australia is a hidden gem.
Deliberately, we haven't come up with a tagline. And the reason being, they can date, they can be made fun of. You know, today we might be the mining state, tomorrow we could be the technology state.
And as Darren zeroed in on his target, he called in creative support.
Ken Kodo designed the Commonwealth Bank logo. It's a corn chip dipped in Vegemite, right? It says nothing about banking.
But you can't mistake it. Enter Ken Kodo. Some eyebrows may go up because he's a Victorian, but he's had his share of winners, BHP and Seven logos amongst them.
With South Australia, this is a battle flag. This is a sign of pride. This is a sign of engaging the whole community.
That shape there.
Is that doable, Dar?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, what we've been able to do is get a laser probe to measure the roof. Because the
local advertising group KWP won the job of launching and marketing the brand. Creative director Peter Withy.
The brand is quite bold. It features a doorway where South Australia is, a doorway that leads into the state, a doorway that looks out of the state. It's show our creativity, show our innovation, show how we get a can-do attitude and get things done.
We're treating each section of the festival theatre as individual panels throughout.
The launch had to be big. And where better to project our imaginations than on the roof of the Festival Theatre?
Oh, it's a massive project, and we brought in Kojo, who are kind of world leaders in some of these areas, and we couldn't have done it without them.
And then from that point, the logo unfolds.
Yep.
And then South Australia.
Excellent.
Comes on.
Yeah, great.
The good thing is that we've got teams here that cover all sorts of areas and fields.
Kojo know a thing or two about getting our attention. The local blokes have been involved in 23 feature movies, The Hobbit and The Lucky One amongst them.
No matter where the viewer's standing, they're always going to get a good angle of the actual projection, a good viewpoint. There won't be any distortion, stuff like that. This sequence depicts the beaches and the seas of South Australia, and then the wave comes in the beginning, comes out of frame and comes in to show the wine. So it's more talking about, you know, the Barossa and the vineyards and the wine industry of South Australia.
Managing Director Dale Roberts says the time pressure has been the biggest challenge.
Various elements are very groundbreaking. We've got huge challenges with logistics, light, the angles of the roof, the fact that there were no CAD data for the roof. We had to have laser measurements done. So we've brought our best animators, designers.
Amazing undertaking. It's the kind of projection that hasn't been done in this state at all. We've previously seen things of this scale in London, Buckingham Palace.
Just so happens one of the key technicians on that project, Nils Poorman, is in Australia, and he too came on board.
It's about being very obvious with light. It's painting with light. I think it was a very good measure of bringing the right element of graphics and the medium together. So medium and message go well here, I think.
As you heard that reverb, that build, and then come through the tunnel.
And nothing moves us without music. Justin Asprey and Justin Pouncett are the composers.
It's definitely a musical score. It's definitely. I mean, it has a lot of different elements, as Justin touched on before. You know, we have the orchestral sections, we have some electronic sections, and sections that we're still writing.
Well, they seem to have got it right on the night. How the people of SA will take it on will be up to them.
You think they got it?
Certainly. The comments that I've heard even since, people understand particularly how flexible it's going to be.
Try this, for example.
And where do you go from here?
Look, the journey has only just begun. There's a team that's been mobilised now that's working on the implementation. The Brand South Australia website will have information on it from 9:30, and we'll roll in tomorrow and we'll start to talk to the people of South Australia and see how they can be involved.
Well, we're certainly keen to